Praise the Lord. I gotta redo this video all over again. Redo this video. I forgot Joshua told me that YouTube is very sensitive when it comes to talking about the pandemic. I can't say the name because they overly sensitive. So I'm gonna go ahead and redo this video. But my daughter India, she still harassing me and Joshua, my oldest son, my firstborn, and she Facebook messaged him first, and then she all out the blue messaged me because I guess she saw my video, you're connected, you're needed, and she went on a rant. She went on a rampage all on my Facebook Messenger. I thought I blocked her. You know, I blocked her messages. I don't know how it was unblocked, but I was blocked it again. She left several audio messages, and I already had contacted her probation officer. And I contacted them by email, but it looks like I'm gonna have to call down. I don't know if it's a man or woman, but I'm gonna have to call call them today, because I'm just tired of this. I really am. For her to keep saying, I'm not her mother, and just a whole bunch of nonsense. This is proof right here. This is the picture. This is her baby picture. This is the original baby picture. This is my son Joshua and her, with the same outfit on as her. It's India. This is a picture of them. See how sad she looked? This is a picture of them at my Aunt Pete's house. At my great Aunt Pete's house. This is my daughter. This is Linda. My daughter, this is the only baby picture I got of her as a baby. Linda, this is Linda. This is India's, you know how they give you this when you have a baby. This is her footprint, and this is the Mercy Hospital thing that they put in the little bed. This was in her bed when I had her, with her date of birth, and it's a baby girl with my last name. It's the back of it, and it kept all this time, because it's, look, see, all this time I kept it all these years. This is my book that explains everything. Me fighting for my children. Fighting for all six of my kids. Talk about psychology. Talk about, and they got pictures. They got pictures of my family. This is the picture that Joshua told me. It's a story behind this. This is the picture that Joshua said that they took. They took it at a mall. That's my sister Indira. That's Indira. That's my son, Joshua. That's India. That's the one that's giving me hell. Causing all this drama and all this mess. That's her. This is my daughter, Linda. And this is a picture that they took. And Joshua said they took it just before they put them up for adoption. So this was like their last visit together. And it's like kind of like a little orphan Annie. Like, you know, like the locket. So in case they split all up and anything, they get older, they can reunite with this picture that they took. And it's in my book. This is the same picture. These are the same pictures that I showed you. That's in my book. That's the same picture right there. That's my daughter Joy and my son Malachi. I had six kids. Three daughters and three sons. This is me. My baby picture. That's me. This is a picture that my son, artwork my son did. That's supposed to be me holding my son. Christian. He did that for me. Yeah. This is a picture that India, my daughter India, sent me. You can see at the bottom, it got India Marie. And this is my parents. That's my parents. And that's my mother holding India, reading a book to India. And that's Linda, my father holding her, Linda. And that's at a supervised visit. That's at DSS. It was a supervised visit that I wasn't invited to. My parents had the visits without me. They had grandparent visits. This is my son, Christian. That's Christian. This is Christian again, my son Christian. This is Sean. This is in my book about how they abduct, how Child Protective Services in the family courts, they illegally kidnap. They legally kidnap children. So my children, all six of them, they were legally kidnapped and put in foster care. And then India was illegally adopted with no constitutional rights, with no due process, with no criminal charges for child abuse, none of that. This says abduction alert. American children have a price on their heads. Crooked judges and so-called family courts issue illicit rights violating court orders for the cops and CPS workers to confiscate your children. Hundreds of billions of dollars have been stolen by the Social Security Trust Fund to finance the family court child trafficking racket. Will your children be next? Help protect your children and those of your relatives, neighbors, friends, co-workers, and church members. Contact the National Coalition for Family Court and CPS Reform. www.punishforbeingaparent.com. Oh, that's in my book. This is Christian, is my son, my youngest baby. This is my grandfather. This is my mother's father. His name is James Vernon Taylor. He was wanted by the FBI in April 1966. And it was all on the Afro-American newspaper. And he drowned himself in the Inner Harbor, Baltimore Inner Harbor. He found him in the Inner Harbor. He shot and killed. He murdered his wife and kids. And one of his children looked just like my daughter, Linda. It looked just like my daughter, Linda. He had a picture. I found her. I went to Enoch Pratt Library, and they sent me an article with the wife and the two kids, and that baby looked just like Linda. Looked just like her. So that's my grandfather. That's my mother's real father. So we have a bad history. Go all the way back before I was even born. I was born in 1970. So that got a lot to do with it. I think that had a lot to do with my children being taken, because the government is government. You got FBI, and that's government. And then you got CPS's government. So they targeted my family. And I think they did that based on old history, past history, before I was even born. I really believe that. This is a picture that India sent me. This is Linda in India. This is India. This is Linda in India. These is pictures that she sent me. And this is my book. You can see it real good. It's on Amazon. It's on Amazon. So, for somebody that's not her mother, and she was separated from her brother, Joshua. They were both taken at the same time from Johns Hopkins, you know, hospital. It was taken in 1998. And this is proof that they was together. I had custody of them. I had the both of them. And India's still bringing it up. She bringing up stuff that she had no control over. I had no control over it. You know, our family was targeted. I talked to Joshua would talk about it even now. Joshua 30 years old. And he said that he seen a lot of kids in the group homes in the 90s that was just like his case. He was targeted for being black. Black families, and it was something, like you said, it was a 90s thing, back in the 90s, that they did. So they took a lot of single parent homes, and they did that. And it's just like, you know, just like the slave trade, you know. Like I said in my other video, it's the exact same thing. It's modernized slave trade. That's what it is. That's exactly what it is. But I'm going to get off of here. I done made this video. And like, share, and subscribe. If you see her on the street, if you see my daughter on the street, go the other way. Don't have nothing to do with it. Don't help her. Don't do like me and Joshua did, because you saw what happened to us. You know, she came in contact with us since 2016. So this been an ongoing thing with her from 2016 to 2022. You know, she's not harassing her father's side of the family. She's attacking us. You know, she's attacking my sister, Endeavor. She's attacking my son. You know, she's harassing me when she's not supposed to be contacting. She not supposed to be contacting me like this. Only reason why I contacted her was because my son was in the hospital and I thought that he was dying. So being that they my oldest two children, that's why I did that. Other than that, I wouldn't have contacted her. I wouldn't have contacted her at all. But like, share, and subscribe. Keep my family in your prayers. Keep my son in your prayers. And be safe. God bless.